Hi. Last day I posted my next part for the homemade planner, and Get Riley have leave some comment. It's a very good idea. Yeah, this. And who is it? Who is this? And I have a similar idea to using this one. That's a nut with a Rändelmutter, heißt das bei uns. I weiß nicht, wie das bei euch heißt. And if I use this, I can do this with the sun. But the problem was, I just have one. So I don't show this. But Get Ready, thanks for the idea. Very cool. And if I need next time someone from Amazon, I will buy this also and I use this instead the regular nuts. I have to make a blade guard and the fence, and I start with the fence first, and the fence is gonna be a plywood here, another strip of plywood here, and a strip of melamine. So I do this first because I have to weigh the glue string, etc., 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 etc. And also I have to make the slots a little bit bigger so I can handle this better. That's also an idea from Get Ready. And again I do all the parts. The motor needs some fresh air, and I have this hole, and I have to make the same hole in the back side for the fence. So that's what I'm gonna do next. I cut the slots a little bigger and I do also a little bit round over the corners. So, and when I become the bigger nuts, I can operate with the sump, the screws and the high. Cool idea, Get. Very cool idea, Get. Riley. So, now I can reassemble all. Dass ich der Röhrig bin, das weiß doch jedes Kind. Crazy Tim. Very nice machine. So, this goes in here, and the cutter head up goes in here, like so. Dun, 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 yeah. I think I'm very close to the first test one. I don't use wood glue because I have to put all again for install this and after for painting if the prototype works correct. Scherzkeks. I learn English on the computer and there are some things like my flowers are beautiful. Oh. Oh. what is this? Oh no. The planer don't work and I have
now wow.
Mach ich jetzt das? Hey, komm, beginne a minute.
Ja, wo gehobelt wird, fallen Späne. Now I have my DNA on the planer.
Normally I want to paint this gray or black or not red. Okay, so in, out. So now I have to get back the washers and the nuts in. Well, no. My hands are too big. I have too big hands. I need someone with little small hands, like a hobbit. Bilbo, come help me. Alter, geht da mal da drauf. Da kriege ich gleich hier, krieg ich gleich graue Haare. So. Hopp. Das ist ein Gefrickel. So. And another one. Frickel. After this, it's time for donut and coffee. Oh no, donut is not a good idea. I have to lose some weight. I'm too fat. So, and another washer. And to fix the fence, I have made these wooden knobs. So it goes in here, like so. I think I cut the corners a little bit off, so the fence looks a little bit nicer. So for the moment, it looks like a very little nice, sweet homemade planer. So. So. Beltguard. I wanna try to make this one piece plywood. So. I don't can close all because fresh air for the motor. I think I use this piece of plywood and drill the inside out so I have place for the belt and the pulleys. Like so. A simple thing. For the most, I think I use this Forstner bit and the rest I chisel out, I think. I screwed up a little bit. Look, I was working with a chisel and I push in the wrong way and I broken this. So I have to make another one. Now I have this. This goes over here. And a little piece of wood, I glue this on here. So, and I have the same. Shit! YouTube is cool. Normally, for the adjustment, I use a ruler and I turn the nuts and this push the in and out free table up and down. But Norman have a really better idea. look the comment here. Norman has the idea to use shims. And I think that's a very good idea. That's a very good idea. So, I think I use this method. That means also I need just one nut under here, and that makes the things a lot easier to adjust. So, thanks a lot, Norman, for this really good idea. Cool, cool. Why is this? It's not my idea. What I like on prototyping, you come up with an idea, you build something, and after you change some, and after you come up with a nice finished product. Here's a little thing, what I want to tell you. Sometimes you cannot, with your regular drill, and in this case, I use this one, in this one, and the drill in here. So now I can go close. And drill the holes. So I was searching around my shop what I use for to shim this, and I have a lot of this plastic plexiglass cutoffs, and I'm pretty lucky. Three of them have the perfect height for the outfeed table. So for this side, cool. And for the infeed table, I have to find another things. Two of them too small and three of them too big. So I have to find some. I was searching around my shop for different things for shimsis, for the in and outfeed table. And I can find nothing. So I take a little break, coffee, and I think I have the idea. I want a plane just a hair every pass. Yes, you know. So instead to find something, it's a bit smaller than this. I make one of this shim a little bit. Bigger.
A little bit bitter.
A little bit bigger. Oh la la. So, and of course, I use duct tape for this. So I take one shim, two or three layers of duct tape, and I have the difference what I'm searching for. And after I can adjust the blades, and I have what I want. Sometimes I have also good ideas. And thanks again, Norman, for the idea with the shims. Very cool. So here my shim with duct tape. And here the shims without duct tape for the infeed table. So and so. And now I have the difference between the infeed. What has happened today? I have the difference between the infeed and the outfeed table. That's all what I need. So you see, shims and duct tape save my planar build. I paint the homemade planer a little bit, and I finish the belt guard. This comes here. Okay. What do you think? We make a quick test run? maybe you put your headphones off. I think it's gonna be a bit loud. So, okay, first test in 3, 2, 1. Cool. And now you can see why I built this this way, instead to use a planer and build just a box around. In my eyes, this looks a little bit nicer and needs much less space. Now I have to make a blade guard and some fine adjustments for the blades and also install the security switch. But I cover this up in another quick video, I promise. So let me know in the comments what you think about this little mini benchtop planer. Maybe I'm wrong and it's not good. Tell me and see you in the next video. Ciao.